Greetings. I received the following question from a seeking brother. He has never identified his worldview, but he asks really good, thoughtful questions. Christians claim that Jesus is God, and since Jesus is God, a God that always existed, it must have meant that he wrote the Old Testament. Since Jesus said in John 10:30, saying he and the Father is one, it meant that Jesus shared the same powers or characteristics of the Father. It must have meant that whatever Jesus would do, the Father would do too. If this is so, then this must mean that Jesus, technically speaking, wrote the Old Testament. Would this be true? That is a great question, brother. Christians believe God inspired the authors of the Old Testament, meaning the prophets. But God did not sit down with pen in hand and literally write, as the claims of Islam about Allah authoring the Quran. But the importance and presence of Jesus in the Old Testament is certainly something worth considering. In fact, Jesus himself stated something along these terms in John 17:5. John 17:5, "And now glorify me, Father, with yourself, with the glory that I had with you before the world existed." So Jesus states that he did exist with God before the world was created, and Jesus shared God's glory during that time before creation. But Prophet Isaiah clearly reveals God never shares his glory with another God. Isaiah 42:8, "I am the Lord, that is my name. I will not share my glory with anyone else, or the praise due me with idols." So Jesus cannot be another God. Jesus must be one, united with God. The Hebrew word is echad. Also, many revelations of the prophets hint at and imply that Jesus is one with God, meaning the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In Zechariah 12:10, the one speaking through Zechariah is the Lord, Yahweh. Zechariah 12:10, "Then I will pour out a spirit of grace and prayer on the house of David and the residents of Jerusalem, and they will look at me whom they pierced. They will mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, and weep bitterly for him as one weeps for a firstborn." This is God talking, referring to the townfolk of Jerusalem who have pierced him. Now, any would argue God cannot ever be pierced. But Jesus was pierced during his crucifixion in Jerusalem. There is only one obvious analysis that makes sense of this. Jesus is the God of the Old Testament. And there are others, such as Malachi 3:1, which reveals God will come to his temple in Jerusalem as a messenger or prophet of the covenant. Malachi 3:1, "Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts." So God sent Malachi with the message that God would send a messenger to prepare the way before God would come to his temple. This is a deep mystery about God, which only God knows and God has revealed by his prophets. Let's look at another part of the question. It meant that Jesus shared the same powers or characteristics of the Father. As I have pointed out, Jesus himself stated something along these terms in John 17:5. "And now glorify me, Father, with yourself, with the glory that I had with you before the world existed." Consider the implication that Jesus is asking God to again share God's glory. This means, at that time, Jesus was not sharing God's glory. So, when did Jesus stop sharing the glory which Jesus says he did share before creation? The Bible tells us that when Jesus came to earth and took on the form of man. Philippians 2:5, let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus, who, existing in the form of God, did not consider equality with God something to cling to, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being made in human likeness. It is this act of emptying himself where he set aside his glory. This is also why, when Jesus walked the earth, he did not enjoy his deity. And having been found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself, having become obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. So Jesus did exist with God's glory and with the powers of God before Jesus came to the earth. It must have meant that whatever Jesus would do, the Father would do too. Perhaps this is only a matter of language, but as you stated it, God follows Jesus' example. Whatever Jesus would do, the Father would do too. Actually, the relationship is reversed, as Jesus stated it. John 5:19. So Jesus replied, "Truly, truly, I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself unless he sees the Father doing it. For whatever the Father does, the Son also does." Jesus only did what the Father would do. John 5:30. By myself I can do nothing. I judge only as I hear, and my judgment is just. For I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me. Jesus did not come as God, but as a servant or prophet of God. This is just as prophet Malachi has said, and I have already cited. John 6:38, for I have come down from heaven. So who comes from heaven? What man would dare claim he came from heaven? Not to do my will. And Jesus identifies having a separate will, one with God, but distinct, but to do the will of him who sent me. John 12:50, I know that his command leads to eternal life, so whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. This fulfills what the prophet of Deuteronomy 18 was to do. Deuteronomy 18:18, I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. So whatever I say is just what the Father has told me to say. I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. Clearly, Jesus is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Jesus repeated this revelation of a will separate from God's in the Garden of Gethsemane. Matthew 26:39. Going a little further, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." And one final part of the question. If this is so, then this must mean that Jesus, technically speaking, wrote the Old Testament. Would this be true? As I mentioned, the Torah and Bible were never offered as books God himself wrote. This is an interesting strategy by Muhammad, to give the Quran an air of credentials. If the Torah or Bible are only written by men, even prophets, but the Quran is written by Allah Himself, then some will be convinced the Quran must be better than the Torah and Bible. But the authority of the Torah and Bible do not arise from the claims of Genesis or how it was written, or magic number 19, or lack of contradiction, or Alif Lam Mim. Those are all topics for other videos. Please let me know if you have any other questions, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.